3 December 2020, and I'm joined by Mr. Albert Matapo from the Zimbabwe People Power Movement. How are you, sir?
I'm fine, I'm fine. Thank you very much, Mr. Gambakwe. How about you?
Very well, thank you very much. Thank you. Today we want to go into a very topical issue. There was a big headline in the Daily News today where Job Scala is said to have said the people in Zimbabwe have suffered enough and it's now time to think about having dialogue with Edi Mnangagwa. So what is your position on this stance that has been taken by Job Scala?
I agree with Mr. Job Scala that the people of Zimbabwe have suffered for far too long. The people of Zimbabwe have seen problems in Zimbabwe for far too long now. They need a solution. However, if it is true that really Job Scala said that, there is need for dialogue with Mnangagwa, I totally disagree with that notion of a dialogue with Mnangagwa. Because a person or a leader who has been rigging elections, stealing elections, and using machinations in different forms from 1980 up to now, Mnangagwa has been doing this together with Mugabe. I don't think any form of dialogue would be helpful with that kind of person. Yes, in most cases, dialogue is the best way to go. I agree. You know, in other circumstances, dialogue is the way to go. But in this case, a person who does not respect the people's choice, where people have voted someone else, and he says no, that person does not need us to get into a dialogue. What it simply means, if it is true that Job Scala has said that, then it means he has run short of ideas, of other strategies that can remove ZANU-PF. And so ZPPM, us as ZPPM, we say no, because we have got a strategy to remove ZANU, to take power from ZANU. So we say no as ZPPM. Thank you.
Okay, so I want to go to the possible strategies that you are talking about. Is it possible to remove Mnangagwa by force?
No. We will never use force. Never, ever. We will not use force. Force is not an option. We have democratic processes. We have democratic systems that we are going to use. I've always said this. Remember, Zimbabweans must remember that I was here on Gambakwe Media on 1 January 2020. And I said that Zimbabweans, we are not going to see 2021 with ZANU-PF in power. Yes, that was my wish, and that is still my wish today. Of course, I think you agree with me that we have had several other things that came in which we never anticipated. By the time on the 1st of January, when I talked of strategies to make sure that we take power from ZANU, I of course, other people knew, but I did not know of this coronavirus that came in to disturb several other systems. One reason. The second reason, of course, is that the people of Zimbabwe have not responded really the way I expected that the people of Zimbabwe should respond and be part of Zimbabwe People Power Movement. There are a lot of people around Zimbabwe who keep on fooling Zimbabweans to follow systems that will not get them to any, freedom. And that has been a setback, a biggest setback for Zimbabwe People Power Movement. However, I don't want the people of Zimbabwe to lose hope. We are going to make it. We are never going to announce the date, but we will make it. I am saying, I have been here on Gambakwe Media and other medias and have expressed our desire as Zimbabweans to free ourselves. We are going to free ourselves if Mnangagwa and team are confident and they say that they were put in place by the people of Zimbabwe. Then surely, why then should the people of Zimbabwe fail to remove? How can we as people of Zimbabwe fail to remove them from power peacefully? We are going to do it, and it is going to be peaceful. We are not a terrorist organization. We are not a violent organization. We are going to do it peacefully. The Americans, I've always said this, that the Americans managed to do it on 4 July 1776. They did it. They used the people power. People power is acceptable, is allowed world over for the people to rise up and say enough is enough. So we are leading people power movement in Zimbabwe, and Zimbabwe people power movement has become the biggest social movement in Zimbabwe. And that is the best way to go. If you are a Zimbabwean and you are still following ZANU-PF today, then you are lost and you don't know what you want. You are, I don't know how to describe you because you do not have any brains. If you are a Zimbabwean and you are still believing in 2023 elections, then you are as good as dead, because 2023 elections are already stolen. We are saying ZANU-PF will not allow any election to remove them. They have told us openly ever since they said you will not remove us by a mere pen. But what they forget is the fact that soldiers, police officers, and all state agents, they come from our homes. They are our brothers, sisters, children, whatever you. And so they do not, they can control them at work when they are putting on uniforms, but they do not control their brains. It is us who can talk to our brothers in our homes. What? Why are we failing to convince our own brothers, our own neighbors, our own friends, our own children that they must go to the side of the people when the people finally make a voice and say enough is enough? There have been problems. I know there are serious problems that we have in Zimbabwe. The major problems that we have are that the people of Zimbabwe, they are easily swayed. They are easily fooled. There are a lot of politicians in Zimbabwe who are fighting for their stomachs, who are fighting for themselves more than the people of Zimbabwe. I wonder if the people of Zimbabwe really know this, that, look, I'm not saying don't follow politicians, but don't believe everything that they say. Today, we have ZANU-PF stealing from one end, and we also have opposition councillors, opposition MPs looting with ZANU-PF. They are colluding and working together in enriching themselves without fighting for Zimbabweans. But Zimbabweans are still fooled to follow that kind of line of thinking instead of saying, no, 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 let's put politics aside and start working as Zimbabweans. Unity of purpose, and so that we can drive ZANU-PF out. Then we can think of politics later on. We can think of our politicians later on. Today, politicians are no longer fighting for us. I am here in front of you saying, let us work together to take power from ZANU. Then we can think of elections. The strategy, the formula to take power from ZANU, we have it.
The problem is our Zimbabweans, they are not coming to the party. So there are bodies like the Zimbabwe People Power Movement, the MDC, and other people who have come up and offered solutions. But the people on the ground, they are folding their hands. And we're moving towards 2023. We will end up on another election if we continue this way. What is wrong with dialogue?
Dialogue is not going to give any solution. It's going to give leverage only to those involved in dialogue. How many people are going to be in dialogue? There are going to be very few people involved in that dialogue, and they will benefit. Right now, if I tell you, I'm sure you are aware that those in Poland have been assured of vehicles and farms. Only the leaders in Poland. And how does that help the nation of Zimbabwe? So whatever dialogue, whatever form of government of national unity that they can plan, that they can get into, will not benefit the people of Zimbabwe. It will be just a cover-up, just for them to get whatever international support that they want, and then they can loot more and more. They can become more and more powerful. So we are totally against any form of dialogue. The only dialogue that the people of Zimbabwe should accept is free and fair election. And free and fair election has failed. We are dedicated to see Zimbabweans free. And we are going to make it together with the Zimbabweans. I can't do it alone. We have to unite. We need people from all corners of Zimbabwe to speak their voices, to talk and say, we are sick and tired. I know, people of Zimbabwe, you are suffering, but you continue to suffer as long as you don't do the right thing, as long as you don't join the people's movement.
Is there anything else you want to say before we close?
I just want to say that, yes, we are still having the petition going on. Quite a number of people, we now have quite a lot of people who have signed. We still haven't submitted it to United Nations. It's an announcement that I need to make. We haven't submitted it to United Nations. We will do it at some point. We are running short of resources to be able to maneuver fast, to do things, you know, in a pace that Zimbabweans would want. We need as much support from Zimbabweans. I don't know how. We need ideas. We need physical resources. We need mutual support. We need all sorts of things. If Zimbabweans can come forward and be part of us, I would be very glad. We would be very glad. So those who have received this message, please pass it to others. Let everybody else know this message and get in touch with me. Let us move together so that then we can get to finality. I thank you, Zimbabwe. Those of you who have come, those of you who are moving with ZPPM, thank you very much. Keep it up. Keep it up, Zimbabweans. Thank you very much.
Right. Thank you very much, Mr. Alban Matapo from the Zimbabwe People Power Movement. Your number is on the screen. If people want to contact you, they can contact you on that number on WhatsApp. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much.